Let us look at the identification and grading of white blood cells. In nearly all cases, modern hematology analyzers provide accurate WBC counts and differentials. However, the differential may be suppressed or inaccurate when there are abnormal white cell populations present, but this will cause abnormal flags to be triggered. WBC differential involves the classification of white cells based on their size, nuclear shape, chromatin pattern, cytoplasmic appearance, and content. The 2008 WHO classification of tumor and hematopoietic and lymphoid tissues recommends a 200 white cell peripheral blood cell differential to be performed as a part of diagnostic workup in AML and MDS. However, a 100 white cell differential is more usual in the routine hematology laboratory. First, we shall have a look on normal myeloid development and morphology. Myeloblasts are blast cells in normal myeloid maturation having a diameter of 12 to 20 microns and a relatively large, round or oval nucleus with a fine chromatin pattern and one or more distinct nucleoli. The cytoplasm is basophilic with an absent Golgi zone and granules may or may not be present. Promyelocytes are 15 to 25 microns in diameter, have an oval or round nucleus with fine or intermediate chromatin and a usually visible and prominent nucleolus. The cytoplasm is basophilic and contains blue to violet and red granules. A pale area equating to the Golgi zone is present adjacent to the nucleus. Myelocyte is slightly smaller than promyelocyte with a diameter of approximately 10 to 18 microns with a round to oval nucleus which may be eccentrically placed. The nuclear chromatin shows a moderate degree of coarse clumping and nucleoli are not seen. There is a moderate amount of blue to pink cytoplasm which contains numerous red to violet granules. As the myelocyte matures, the secondary granules develop definite neutrophilic, eosinophilic or basophilic characteristics. Metamyelocyte is smaller than the myelocyte with an indented or kidney-shaped nucleus. Nucleoli are not observed. The cytoplasm is usually clearly pink and contains granules that are clearly differentiated as neutrophilic, eosinophilic or basophilic. Immature granulocytes, that is promyelocytes, myelocytes and metamyelocytes, are not usually seen in normal peripheral blood. Band neutrophils are 10 to 14 microns in diameter and have a nucleus that is non-segmented or have rudimentary lobes that are connected by a thick band rather than a thread. Cytoplasm is abundant, pink and contains many small violet to pink neutrophilic or secondary granules distributed evenly throughout the cell. Many laboratories do not report band neutrophils on adult patients or children due to inter-observer variation in band neutrophil classification. It is recommended that band neutrophils be counted as segmented neutrophils in the differential. Appropriate comments may be made if increased numbers are seen in the blood film. Segmented neutrophil is 10 to 14 microns in diameter with a lobulated nucleus, usually with 3 to 4 lobes, but small number of 2 and 5 lobe neutrophils may also be seen. This lobulated nucleus is connected by a thin thread of chromatin. The chromatin is coarse, stains violet, and is arranged in clumps. There is abundant pink cytoplasm with many small secondary granules. Eosinophils are 12 to 17 microns in diameter, with the nucleus having only 2 lobes, with coarsely clumped violet staining chromatin. There is abundant cytoplasm containing many eosinophilic or orange secondary granules that are larger than neutrophil granules and more uniform in size. Basophils are 10 to 16 microns in diameter with pale blue cytoplasm containing purple-black secondary granules which are water-soluble and may dissolve on staining, leaving clear areas in the cytoplasm. The nucleus is segmented but is often obscured by basophilic granules which may vary in number, size and shape. Monocytes are the largest cells in the peripheral blood, variable in size but usually 15 to 22 microns in diameter. The nucleus is irregular in outline, often kidney-shaped, and chromatin is arranged in fine strands with sharply defined margins. The cytoplasm is light blue to gray and contains numerous fine dust-like granules. Some cells may contain a small number of red to violet granules. Vacuolation may be present. Now coming to normal lymphocyte development and morphology. Lymphoblast has a diameter of 8 to 20 microns. The nucleus is round or oval with fine granular chromatin and one or more indistinct nucleoli. The cytoplasm is scanty and basophilic, and cytoplasmic granules are absent. It cannot be reliably distinguished from some types of undifferentiated or minimally differentiated myeloblasts and therefore should be counted as a blast cell. Prolymphocyte has a round nucleus and a single prominent nucleolus. It has more cytoplasm than a lymphoblast and the chromatin is more condensed. Lymphoblasts and prolymphocytes are not usually seen in the normal peripheral blood. Lymphocytes seen in the peripheral blood are predominantly small, about 10 to 12 microns, or less frequently large, 12 to 16 microns. Small lymphocytes are usually round in outline and nucleus is round with coarse, densely staining chromatin. Cytoplasm is scanty. Large lymphocytes are usually irregular in outline and the nuclear chromatin is not as coarse as in small lymphocyte. Cytoplasm is abundant and tends to be light sky blue in color. Large granular lymphocytes, also called LGLs, are of the same appearance as large lymphocytes, but the cytoplasm contains prominent small red to violet granules. These cells can comprise up to 10 to 20% of the peripheral blood lymphocytes in normal subjects and are not routinely counted as a separate lymphocyte population. It is recommended that LGLs be counted as lymphocytes but may be commented on if they are present in increased numbers, which may prompt further investigations such as flow cytometry. Lymphocytes predominate in the blood films of infants and children until 4 years of age, and these lymphocytes are more pleomorphic than those seen in normal adult blood films. Coming to quantitative abnormalities, neutrophilia, neutropenia, lymphocytosis, lymphopenia, monocytosis, monocytopenia, eosinophilia, eosinopenia, basophilia and basopenia are quantitative abnormalities of white blood cells. The automated white blood cell differential count is less time consuming and expensive than the manual method, and as an analyzer counts thousands of cells compared to the usual 100 to 200 WBCs by the microscopic method, it will also be more precise in the absence of abnormal cell populations. Very low or high white cell counts may also cause the manual differential to be less accurate and reproducible. It is recommended that the automated analyzer WBC differential count be reported in patients with normal cell populations in the absence of analyzer flags or abnormal cell populations that cannot be reliably differentiated and classified by automated instruments. Coming to qualitative abnormalities in myeloid cells. First, we shall look at cytoplasmic abnormalities. OR rod is a sharply defined red rod or needle-like cytoplasmic inclusion formed by abnormal primary granule development, which is found mainly in leukemic myeloblasts or abnormal promyelocytes, staining positively for myeloperoxidase and are a specific marker for myeloid lineage neoplasms. They may be several in a cell and may be arranged in bundles, in which case they are called as faggots. The recommendation is to report the presence of OR rods when seen. Dole bodies are pale, light blue or grey, single or multiple cytoplasmic inclusions found near the periphery of the neutrophil and are a non-specific reactive change, but may also indicate Mehaglin anomaly if associated with thrombocytopenia and giant platelets. Hypergranulation or toxic granulation in neutrophils are coarse, purple staining primary or azurophilic neutrophilic cytoplasmic granules, which occur as a response to infection and inflammation, which is a non-specific reactive change as a result of abnormal primary granule maturation with retention of their azurophilic staining properties. Hypogranulation of neutrophil is reduced or absent neutrophil granulation, causing the cytoplasm of mature neutrophils to appear bluish-gray. Vacuolation of neutrophil in infection is due to granule fusion with a phagocytic vacuole and release of lysosomal contents to kill bacteria. This vacuolation may appear as pinhole vacuolation with small or discrete vacuoles, but the vacuoles may be larger. Other causes of neutrophil vacuolation include alcohol toxicity and prolonged exposure to EDTA anticoagulant, the latter being as a storage artifact. The recommendation is to grade Dole bodies, hypergranulation, hypogranulation, and vacuolation when seen. Coming to nuclear abnormalities, neutrophil hypersegmentation is defined as any neutrophil having 6 or more lobes or more than 3% of neutrophils having 5 lobes when 100 neutrophils are examined. The recommendation is to comment on the presence of hypersegmented neutrophils when seen. Hyposegmented or hypolobated neutrophils are marked by the failure of normal nuclear lobe development during terminal differentiation and have coarse clumped nuclear chromatin. They are mature neutrophils and should not be confused with myelocytes, metamyelocytes, or band neutrophils. They can be differentiated by their smaller nucleus and lower nuclear to cytoplasmic ratio and condensed nuclear chromatin. It is recommended that hyposegmented neutrophils be counted and reported as mature segmented neutrophils, but with a suitable interpretive comment.